In step two, we're going to remove the series inductor. So at this point, we have that low pass filter prototype shown on the left there with two shunt capacitors and one series inductor. And we're going to get rid of that. We can get rid of that inductor by using capacitors and inverters, and I'm going to show you how. So the outline is that we can use an inverter to replace the series inductor. And the inverter can be implemented using transmission lines. In fact, anywhere we see a transmission line, there's a reasonable chance that we will see the action of an inverter. And that is indeed what we're going to achieve with our parallel coupled lines. It's not for certain that we will be able to replace the transmission lines by inverters, or going the other way around, replace inverters by transmission lines, but very often we can. Let's review what we know about an inverter. An inverter is a two-port, as shown there. K indicates that this is an impedance inverter. If we had a J there, that would indicate an admittance inverter. It's exactly the same element. It's just whether we do the calculations with ohms or with Siemens. If we had a 50 ohm impedance inverter, we'd actually have 50 ohms replacing that K. So it's pretty clear what's going on. But when we keep things symbolically, we need to use a convention like J's and K's. Now, a lambda on 4 length of line is also an inverter. And the basic property of an inverter is that the input impedance of a terminated inverter, and here the inverter is terminated in a load ZL, the input impedance is equal to K squared over ZL. So let's look at our line. Here is a line. When you first covered inverters, you looked at the equivalence between a line and the inverter using ABCD parameters. That's the correct way of verifying the equivalence, because then you're doing it for a two-port. Now we're going to show the equivalence another way. This is a lossless telegrapher's equation. We're dealing with a lambda on 4 long line. So beta L is equal to pi on 2, so that's a quarter of 2 pi, which is the equivalent of a full wavelength. So tan beta L is tan pi on 2, and that's equal to infinity. So our telegrapher's equation now becomes Z in equal to Z0 times JZ0 tan beta L over JZL tan beta L, because tan beta L is going off to infinity, so the ZL and Z0 terms on their own can be dropped. Of course, the tan beta L's now cancel, and we end up with Z in equal to Z0 squared over ZL. What that means is that if we have a small load at the end of our transmission line, we can greatly enlarge the value of that impedance, scaling it by the characteristic impedance squared of the transmission line. So an inverter can be realized using a transmission line. And nearly always, wherever there are lambda on 4 long transmission lines, an impedance inverter can be realized, possibly. Let's consider our comb line section and the network model for it. Comb line section is shown on the left here. Here is our network model. We see two possible inverter elements. So that's one property I use a lot when I look at microwave circuits. If there are transmission lines there, and if the transmission lines are lambda on 4 long, I'm thinking that there is perhaps an inverter action. So let's get back to replacing the series inductor. We, of course, do not want an inductor to appear in our circuit. When we translate that to a bandpass filter, that inductor will become a series LC circuit, and we really don't want that. That series LC circuit looks like a short circuit at resonance, and so the stub equivalent of that is going to be an open circuited stub. And we saw that for a comb line filter structure, that the simplest model for a comb line filter structure is a pi arrangement of shorted stubs, not an open stub. So we don't want an open stub to appear. That inductor on the left is equivalent to that structure of capacitors and inverters and transformer shown on the right. To demonstrate the equivalence, we need to use ABCD parameters. The ABCD parameters for the inductor on its own are shown here. We're using the T matrix for our ABCD parameters. Here is the ABCD parameter for our inverter, for our shunt capacitor, and for our unity inverting transformer. For the cascade, we can multiply the T parameters together. So the T of the cascade is T2, T1, T2, T3. T2 is the ABCD matrix of our inverter. When we multiply it all out, we get this final expression here. This is very similar to the expression for the series inductor on its own, and it's identical if the value of the inductor is equal to C times K squared. Now, in the prototype we're dealing with now, K is just equal to 1, but just imagine if K was 50 ohms. So if K was 50 ohms, K squared is 2500. So we could take a very small value of capacitance and realize a large value of inductor. So that's another advantage to using an inverter. So what we've shown here is the series inductor is equivalent to this structure with two inverters, a capacitor, and an inverting transformer. But in fact, we can go one step further and get rid of that inverting transformer, because all that inverting transformer does is change the phase. It changes the phase by the same amount, 180 degrees, at all frequencies. So it has no effect on the response of our filter. The only possible impact it has is on the phase by shifting the phase by 180 degrees, but that only matters if we connect the output back to the input. And for the type of filters that we're dealing with here, that doesn't happen. We have taken our lumped element, low-pass prototype filter, we've got rid of the series inductor so that there are only capacitors, and each of those capacitors becomes a shorted stub when we convert it to bandpass filter form, and we have inverters. So here's an interesting thing. Our inductance value is our inductor here in the original prototype was 1.1 henries, and it becomes 1.1 farads in our transform circuit. We have two low-pass prototype filters here, one on the left and one on the right. The low-pass prototype filter on the right has inverters. Now we could short-circuit things a little bit here. On the top here is shown our generic Chebyshev filter with G values. We can transform that circuit by replacing all of the series inductors by inverters and shunt capacitors. That is what's done in that middle prototype circuit. And finally, our form becomes that form on the bottom because we can delete the inverting unity transformers because they don't have any effect except for a 180 degree phase rotation, the same phase rotation at all frequencies. We could have started our design using this bottom form of the generic form of the low pass prototype. But we started with an earlier form so we can look at all of these developments on the way through. In summary, this is the inverter form of the low pass prototype filter. Everything is starting to fall into place here. We know those capacitors are going to be converted to shorted resonators. We know those capacitors are going to be converted to shorted stubs. We know those inverters are going to be somehow realized by lengths of transmission line.